Hello everyone and welcome to Starlight. We are finally done with this freakazoid thing and I'm just going to get started because we're going to be in for a long, long tour. So you can tell where we are from here. Over here is the tower. You've seen this built. Dress this up a little bit in here with some random stuff. So out here, the first stop is Doc Anderson. She is a vet slash field medic, so here's her field hospital. It's outside the gates, so they don't have to go inside to get her services.
Not many doctors around these days. She let me take a look.
She lives a little rough, but she likes it. She doesn't seem to complain very much. Of course, she never will. Here's the waiting area, such as it is. A lot of cows hanging out in here. That's why I made her a vet. It just made sense. Sometimes there's actually Brahmin inside that place. So here's the front gate. Got my guard up there. Turret. Welcome to Starlight Drive-In, Northwest Hub. There's some stuff over there. We might get to that later, but for now, let's go inside the front gate. There's a turret here on the left, just in case anybody gets sassy. And then on the right, if they do, well, this one's gonna do for them. Now this tour is going to be long, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause at certain spots so I can timestamp the description. So here's the final warehouse that I came up with. That'll be the second part of it. Down there's the hospital. And we have one of our two scavers. He works on if he welds the front of that truck. Okay, so here we go to the marketplace. Marketplace and the kitchen is going to be our first stop. So here's the marketplace. Oh my God, this place is so huge. Just for reference, I filled up the size bar 3 times and it's currently on 75% of the way to the floor. So this is approximately 6 times bigger than anything I have ever done. And oh my God, I will never do a build this big ever again. So here's the top deck. This is the commanding officer, the CO's station here. She'll sit here with a clipboard. That's a scavenging mat. And here's where she does her reports, radios in, does her thing. We got one guard over here. Every guard has only one station, so they're always there. They never move. So I could put their sleeping bags here because they never sleep in them. It doesn't really matter. Here's their little hut. Go up here. Here's guard number 2. Marketplace down there. And guard number 3 is missing. Probably is underneath. They probably fall through. Hopefully all my vendors are where they're supposed to be. Because with so much stuff, they tend to get a little lost. So there's the party patio. Over here is the employees only area. With a little break table, ice machine. Here is the main power armor repair station. Both workbenches, extra parts, lots of tools. All their stuff is underneath the wing here. Let's go into the kitchen. Kitchen's here. Under the stairs, we've got some storage, some random stuff, lunch pails for those people who want to take their lunch to go. Here's the first of 2 generator rooms. Work table. Coffee. Yay, coffee. And a fusion core generator right up against the building on top of the wing. I think I came out pretty good. Close the door there. Go up here. Up here we have the monitoring station. Various status readouts. That's the vault tech assignment terminal. They can see pretty much the whole place from up here. And then we've got a little rest area for him when he's on break to have a cigarette. Just take a break. Here's the main kitchen from the back. I blocked off the shelves in the back with more countertops because I was not about to fill those up with stuff because there is so much stuff in here. Holy crap. So there's that. And then over here, under the wing on the other side, we have the pantry. Refrigerator. The meat from Sunshine. Vegetable crates from wherever and everywhere. And go down here. Food prep area, food scales, kitchen scales, extra silverware, lots of Nuka-Cola.
Thank you. Yep. It's like I can finally think straight.
Sheffield is my chef because, hey, Sheffield. Okay, yeah, I'm a little loopy after working on this thing for so long. Oh, God. Yeah, there's my guard. She must have got stuck underneath. So here's the gathering area at night. The diner area, as it were. Jukebox, had to turn it off because the music in that thing gives you copyright strikes. It gives you those little warnings. So under here we have the weapons testing range. I guess you can test your weapons against these crates sitting on pallets. Trash area back here. Garbage cans, dumpster. And the first of our vendors. That mini nuke moves around. I don't know what's up with that mini nuke. So here's my weapons vendor. This guy and this guy are twins. They're brothers. They got the Lemmy mustache and the same voice. So I figured it'd be funny to make them weapons and armor brothers. So go up in the APC here. Diamond City one of these days.
Biggest town I ever saw.
Little display showroom here, weapons, ammo. Lots of different varieties because Starlight gets everything from everywhere. They get everything. I mean, literally, I can put anything I wanted in here because they have 11 settlements feeding them. Got a guard dog. Here's his armor display. I really like the lockers for the armor display. I mean, you got to group select them to get them in there with USO, but it worked pretty good. Here's his workshop trailer. Now, this workshop trailer, I did not create this. I totally stole this. If you go to Sunshine Tidings and climb up to the Gunner Outpost, this is exactly what they have up there, these two side buildings. With this, you know, the double arch metal wall and this weird cobbled together odd roof and wall combination. Yeah, I had to group select that in there. It wouldn't go in, but it did clip, which was nice. So you can work on your armor and weapons up here. And then
hurts. My feet hurt. Everything hurts.
We have a little resting area for shoppers. Secondary storage over here. You'll notice that this whole thing encloses itself with various obstacles, which I like a lot. This came out really good, I think, in terms of being convincing. There's nothing in the old workshop. I built up around it and towards it, but I didn't put anything in it. And you go up here and you have a missile turret on the roof. Here's Anne Hargraves. She has her own clothing shop. She's very happy with her upscale sort of look here. I'll just pan around here. That's fairly simple. First time I've ever used the armor racks for mannequins, so there's my nod to Phoenix because she used the hell out of those things.
We put on some wonderful radio.
She has a cap because of course she does. It's just, of course she does. Some more clothing, her fresh flowers. Stole those right out of the Institute. So there's her shop. Now we're going to go to the Vault Tech shop. The Vault Tech rep, and of course bathrooms, restrooms. You can clean up here. Pretty straightforward. I used the metal corners. Because that centerpiece could slide in there really easy when I did that. So, yeah, there's the two bathrooms. I finally used restrooms. All my settlements have never had restrooms. So here's the Vault Tech rep's shop. He is going to sell vault stuff. He loves the vault stuff. So I put him in Vault Tech armor and the thing, and he's like,
"Oh, things are looking up. I can feel it this time."
Hell yeah, they are, man. You're selling vault stuff. So I figure all the looting they do to get the vault stuff goes to him. He buys it all. And he sells it in his little showroom here. Hell, he even ripped off the door frame from one of them. So here's his display. Pip-Boys, Vault Tech, suits. Got crates full of stuff. He is all set to go. And we'll go look at his living quarters here. More storage under the sinks here.
As smooth as a baby.
This missile turret does a really good job taking things down on that back hill. And here's, not enough light. So here's his room. All vault stuff. I gave him all vault stuff because, I mean, if anybody deserves good, nice vault stuff, it's that poor bastard. Here's his sitting area, his kitchen. His picture of Imogene. I'm of the mind that the Vault Tech rep has a crush on Imogene. Because, I mean, you think about it, right? You find him in Good Neighbor. He could be anywhere. He could have been in Bunker Hill. He could have been roaming around. But no, he's hanging out in Good Neighbor. Why is he hanging out in Good Neighbor? Because Imogene hangs out in Good Neighbor. And she was a socialite, right? So before the war, she was probably in magazines, radio shows. And Mr. Vault-Tec rep got a crush on her. That's why he hung out in Good Neighbors. He could talk to her when she came by with all her various lovers. So I don't know if that, I'm thinking he probably never told her who he was. So anywho, that's why I put that picture there. That's kind of involved. Another resting area, vending machines, little table they can hang out here. Now here's my favorite shop. Here's Trader Riley, and she is a scav master. Scrap central here. She does not mess around. Piles and piles of just random crap from everywhere. She's like, I will sell anything, but I like hardware. So she has lots and lots and lots of salvaged hardware from God only knows where. Her faithful guard dog, junkyard dog, seems appropriate because it's a junkyard.
Big ugly bastards.
Yeah,
sure,
they hit you hard. Yeah. So here's Riley's store. I'm really starting to have fun with these junk piles. I don't know why it's so much fun to do this. Probably because they're all, you know, USO things, so they're placeable. She's got her whiskey in a shot glass.
Sale. Care to have a look?
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Yes.
And then there's the side door here in the bottom of the wall. And the wall looks like this. Really big fan of those double-sided, double-stacked walls in USO. USO is really nice. Now, I could not find the helipad. I had a helipad, and then it went away, and I don't know where it went. So if you see the helipad in USO, can you leave a note in the comments and tell me where to find it? Because I really wanted it for this build. So there's the market. There's the everything. And see the guards keeping an eye on things from up there. So here comes the first pause. We're going to pause right over here for a couple seconds so I can put a timestamp in the description so y'all can see just what you want to see. And 1001. All right. So the second section here is on the warehouse and the foreman's office. Now, in Hangman's, I wanted to put power armor to show how they move stuff around without a forklift, but I forgot. So they have three suits here. All mix and match, all just whatever they can cobble together. Just something that's big, heavy, durable, that can lift stuff. No helmets, though. They don't like the helmets. There's my Mr. Handy Fuel there. Got to have one of those in every one. Some more random scrap parts, extra jumpsuits in case they get sweaty. Over here, we've got couple of spare backup suits with just, you know, pieces of whatever, wherever, and chain link fence around everything. And I love these little capsules. I've been waiting for these for so long. So here's what they do, the initial paperwork for the warehouse. Lots of coffee, extra boxes on the floor, and the workstation area. I looked at a lot of capsules to try and figure out how, you know, the pre-war people sorted their stuff out, and this seems about right. This doesn't seem like it's too obnoxious. So here's the warehouse. Also, I wanted to mention at this point, if you want to know how any of this was built, just let me know and I can make a video, and I'll go through in build mode and just show you how everything's put together. So here's the warehouse. Food on the left, because this is the in and out. This is going to be the high traffic area here. Here's their weapons and ammo and all the stuff they find in various spots. Over here we have all the appliances and big salvaging things that they're going to be scrapping at some point. And of course, want to keep those near the door because they're big and heavy and you don't want to have to move them very far. Back here we have our barrels and boxes, stuffed to the rafters with crap they've dragged out of the ruins. All right, there's that. And then a little water station, random cups. Restricted area, because upstairs is the administrative area and it's where they keep all the chems. All the chems, all the drugs, all the medicine, everything's on these shelves. There's lots of it. And then here's the office. About as bare bones as it gets. This person does a lot of paperwork. a lot of paperwork, and I forgot to put the shotgun up on that thing. Pretend there's a shotgun on that rack. Over here, we got some more defense to cover the run where the provisions go through, and then extra ammo for the machine guns, the turrets, and then the roof is glass with one light. Some actual exposed wires here. You don't see a lot of those in my builds, but there are some there. I really like how that came out. The little light behind the I-beam there. The other way, the other one's the same way. So there's the warehouse. Let me close that door here. Boop. Okay. So here's, and then of course now the next stop is the clinic, hospital, whatever. I'm going to give a shout out to Counter Magic.
Blisters I got.
Counter Magic, I'll link his channel in the description. Had some really, really nice ones in nice rooms in his sanctuary build. So I just totally stole them. I'm not even ashamed of that. They were so good. I'm never going to improve on it. So here's the clinic, and here's your entryway. Got your waiting area. Towels and other stuff on little portable carts. Medical supplies getting trucked in. Reception area. Typewriter and terminal, just to make sure, because they double up on stuff. Okay, so three examining rooms with three different doctors. Examining room one is our GP. She's our regular old level 3 doctor. And so she has the widest variety of tools and note-taking and documentation and, you know, diagnostic equipment. Diagnostic room two. Room two is our face surgeon. So she has the station. A lot of cutting and grinding and sewing implements here. Hamper for the bloody towels because she probably produces quite a few of them. And then room three is our surgeon. We stole him from the Pridwin. So he's lots of blood packs, lots of towels, x-rays. This is the advanced room here.
Not many doctors around.
And of course
days.
A chair for observation so he can train people. And the stairway's over here. Go up to the top deck. Got the waiting area upstairs. So I gotta turn the light on. It's fine. No, I'll leave it off. So here's the waiting area. Very sunny. I had to actually group select those half wall pieces onto the glass because the height wasn't right. And basically this entire room is group selected. It was actually pretty easy to do once I figured out how to do it. The key is to snap all the windows together because they snap, and then just kind of slide everything else in the roof and the bottom rails, and then just pick the whole thing up and drop it on top of the building. So here's a little bit of a waiting area. Got those. Reading material, empty bottles, vending machines. Doesn't hold a lot of people, but there's only three examining rooms, so there's not going to be a lot of people hanging out here. So here's a slow pan of it, of what it looks like from up here. Yeah, the sun's going down. Jesus, it's taking so long to do this. All right, let's go back downstairs. I'm going to leave all the doors open because, okay. So now we're going to pause here because those are the areas we're going to stop in the next part. And off we go. So there's the back door into the marketplace. There's the wall made up of various elements there. A lot of it is the backs of houses. It just makes sense that the backs of houses would be walls. So I got some extra barrels with some dirty water. Because as they come out and tap the pool here, they need somewhere to put it. And then you have your maintenance equipment, keep the water pump running. When this place gets attacked, that thing gets blown up almost every single time. I mean, they go right for it. And of course, there's no defenses, so they're, you know, as soon as they hit it, it just explodes. But I think I fixed it like 7 times. That little trivia too, I'm in survival mode. So I have to eat and drink and sleep and stuff like that. I went through 390 noodle cups do in this place. So here's the residential quarters. Here's where everybody stays. They all have their various sections, but here's their thing. We have some, turn the light back on. We have one crop room, one crop area here, and then we have another crop area over here. Chain link fences. My farmers are wearing long johns and like metal armor, metal and raider armor, because they're not doing so hot, but it's good for them. So here's the first area. A little seating area for hanging out after work. Got the missile turret on pallets, covering that back hill. This thing gets a lot of action because there's a spawn spot up that hill. So here's where the two scavengers sleep. This is where they live. So they decided to just take their work home with them. And they just leave all this stuff everywhere. Little projects going, dinking around with stuff in the chair here. Give you another look at the rest area here. Milk and cookies here. I'm not sure what I did that for, but okay. And then we go upstairs. And up here is where Sheffield, Riley, and the two brothers sleep. I left stuff by their bed so I could tell whose bed was who. Like, this is Riley's because she's a scabber. This is, well, I think he figured out this is Sheffield. And then this is the armor guy. He likes his Med-X. Feeling burly. And then, of course, here's the weapons vendor. So there's their little house there. Go back downstairs. I don't know. This seemed like a hotel, so here's your little hotel vending area. Okay, now here's where the guard commander sleeps. This is her cot with her extra set of combat armor underneath. Her reporting stuff, extra ammo, extra stuff, a trunk for all her extra supplies. This is basically her work table. She doesn't spend a lot of time here. And here's where the doctors sleep. So the doctors have their own cots, their own suitcases, little books. Did those as a homage to Stacy because she showed me how to use them. I still don't like them, but that actually came out pretty good. And then extra tools they were using. Stuff I stole out of the Institute. And here's their research area. Here's the R&D. Why does this door keep opening? Close yourself. So here's what they do, their experiments, their research, whatever they have in terms of hobbies. So tools, mentats, crap I ripped out of the Institute. They basically go wherever their curiosity takes them. So there's all kinds of varying scientific projects here. And then the refrigerator holds all the stuff that needs to stay cold. Secondary plot, more farmers.
Crop's been growing pretty good lately.
That's because you're doing good work, son. They both have their own water pump. And then the farmers have their own little farmhouse, their own little residence, where they pretty much stated themselves. They're not too keen on this whole marketplace, lots of travelers thing. So they got their own fridge, their own stove. Typical farmhouse, extra armor and weapons, some random stuff, their gathering area, eating area, what have ya. And here is the communications array, so we're going to go around it from this way. It's really getting late. So this is the generator room. Oh, I forgot to reset the light, damn it. Another fusion generator. All the tools and supplies they need to do this. Extra toolbox down there. I'll go slow here so you can see everything. But it's mostly just parts. Parts and a little decorative plant. It fit in that basket kind of nice, so I figured I'd do that. It looks kind of cool. So there's the second generator room. And then down here, we have the communications room, and that spotlight, of course, is not working because I forgot to reset it. Communications Logs Archive. This is where they do their work. Secure records go in the safe. And lots of terminals, lots of storage, lots of everything, because Starlight is the hub. They have to keep track of communication from 11 outlying outposts. So they're busy a lot of the time. And there's that. Oh. And here are the dishes. All the dishes point, of course, they point right to where they point to every single settlement. They all have their own dish, except for Sanctuary and Red Rocket. They share one. Powered up, all the way up top. And since I sealed the doors, what you have to do to get up to the top is go through the window. But it worked out pretty good. The height worked out pretty good. And then there we are. There's all of our dishes. You can finally build these in USO, guys, by the way. I saw them the other day. I wanted to let you know you don't have to do what I did and start a brand new game to use these things. You can use them right through USO. The console's in there. All the pieces of the relay are in there. So let's see what it looks like up from the top. Let's go to the middle. So here it is, guys. Here's Starlight. Here is probably 150 to 180 hours of building, rebuilding, testing, decorating, blah, 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 blah. I don't think I will ever do this again. These epic builds, I don't have the mentality for this or the patience. I mean, it was fun. As long as I treated it like six different settlements, it worked out pretty good. So I'm gonna run on the back here, just so you can see what it looks like on the outside. There's not really much to see, but this is where I hide all my wires. You can see all my conduits, all my wiring. I run them up. Oh, that's right. I forgot. He's overburdened. So I got to go slow here. So here's the back of the... Now this piece here, this double piece here, this thing is tricky to use. It's in a USO and it's kind of tough. I mean, because it doesn't really work. It doesn't snap. It goes down. It doesn't stay straight, so you can't really tuck stuff underneath it as easily. Let's go around the back here. So here's what an attacker sees. Just barrels and walls. There's really nothing for them to see back here. Then the back of the truck has got some other stuff on it to make it... I love these chain link fences. Have I said that enough? I love these chain link fences. But if they go up here, they can't really do anything. You can jump over here, but then you get a turret in the face. And then this is the pantry. This is what it looks like from the back. Wedging those things in with groups like, wasn't too bad. Really wasn't too bad. So, okay. So there's that. It's afternoon. I'm going to go ahead and take a little quick nap and we'll do a real quick run through at night. I will be right back. And here we are at nighttime. We're going to just go through this really quick. I'm not going to go through the details. I'm just going to kind of peek into places. You can see kind of what the lighting is like. I hadn't realized how bright that marquee sign is. Wow, that thing is really bright. So here's your turrets. There's a warehouse. Where did you put your script, Anne? I've never heard your radio show. Isn't it weird that there's no radio show? She always talks about the radio plays, but there's no channel where WRVR is on. They do gather here at night. They just hang out here with Sheffield. There's apparently there's a NPC stand spot right behind him. So it looks kind of...
I really should study my lines.
Looks kind of weird with the...
Got any scab to sell?
Yeah, they just kind of crowd him. Personal space, not an issue here in the old Commonwealth. So there's the kitchen.
You hear about that farm run by ghouls? Isn't that something?
A peek under here. This is what the underbelt looks like with the employee area. And then Riley's place over here. And that's weird. Oh, it's the quantum that's making it so bright. So here's the store. And the restrooms. And Anne's store. Workshop. Oop, and a beam in my face. Street light to light up the extra storage there. Cozy little area there. Spotlights light up his inventory at night, even though he doesn't actually work at night. And then this thing, that fluorescent light, looks really good in here. I mean, it lights it up, well, it's bright as hell, but it's not obnoxiously bright. Like, I tried the spot bulb first, and it was not happening. So there's that. Here's Riley's from the side. I really liked Riley's. And the hospital. Lighting's not too bad. Nice and well lit, but not super, super bright. There's that. Let me go up the stairs here. Waiting area is dim. Just in case somebody wants to take a nap while they're waiting or something. You know, I'm not going down the stairs. I'll just jump. This thing is dark because there's no reason for it to be lit up at night. And then we have the living quarters here. So this is definitely one of the brighter settlements I have, but then it's a marketplace, you know, it's the major area for the northwest side. It's got to be noticeable. And there's that. Go up there. And then down here. Of course, that's going to be bright because it's vending machines. There's the CO's place and then the doctor's place. And of course, their lab is lit up like crazy because they're doing science in here. And then we go down here. Out the gates. And farmer house, which is much more my normal speed. This size of building, this type of building, this is pretty much what I do. And then we'll go back over this way and we'll pan up to see all the scaffolding and all the antenna. You know, I should reset that light maybe. It would look good at night, but it does illuminate just in front of the door, which is what it's supposed to do. And of course, this is very bright. Gotta be bright. So they can keep track and make notes and do their things. All right, folks, that will do it for this one. I think we're done with Starlight and Rodrigo. Senor Aitor, here you go, dude. Here's Starlight. It's finally done, and oh my God. Oh my God, this is the hardest one I have done, I think, ever. Oh, here, let's look behind here. The chain link fences go back behind everything. So you can see the back of the thing here. It's, I think it came out really good. It's, he's panting because I'm carrying all the stuff out of the workbench so it would load faster. And he's carrying, 23 tons of stuff, so he's moving a little slow right now. And the warehouse. Oh, I didn't go inside the warehouse. Duh. Let me go back inside the warehouse really fast, and then we'll call this a day. But yeah, I kind of like doing this. It's kind of nice to have finally done what people might call an epic build, you know? Because I don't really do epic build. I do small things or intricate things, but I don't do really huge, monstrous, multi-element, you know, builds. But this thing definitely is. I'm seriously, 4 size bars at Starlight? I can't believe my game's not crashing. It's a testament to the strength of, I don't even know what. I don't even know where that was going. We'll just run with it. So yeah, so there's the warehouse. Warehouse is all done, and the Northwest Hub is in the can. We are done with the Northwest Hub. Next is, I don't know what's next. I am, honest to God, I'm almost so burnt from doing this. I just want to sleep. But I do want to thank you for watching. I do want to thank all your subscribers for continuing to watch these things. I really hope these are giving you ideas, that you're enjoying this, and that this has proven to be of value. I mean, I like doing it. It's fun, but it's nice to know that people look at this stuff and go, hey, that's kind of cool. I'm going to steal that. Please, please steal it. Steal it. And with that, I will see you in the next one. Take care.